Hi, in this video we'll be talking about string indices. Strings can be indexed in both directions. We use zero-based indices in the forward direction and negative one-based indices in the backward direction. We can print a particular character from the string by using its index in square brackets. So here is our text variable with this string assigned to it. This is a text. And now suppose we want to print the first element of this string, which is the element with index 0. So let me do that. And this is capital T, this character. If I want to print the 15th character, I need the character at index 14. So text with index 14, which is the period. Sometimes it's more comfortable to use negative indices, especially if you need to retrieve the last element of a string. Normally, if you want to retrieve the last element of a string, you'd have to do something like this. Text with the index equal to the length of text minus 1. We have to subtract 1 at the end because indices are zero-based. So, if our text is 15 characters long, which is the length of the text, then the last character is at index 14, 15 minus 1. Okay, and here the result is the period. This is the last element over here. Well, this works, but it's easier to do it this way. Text with a negative index of negative 1. And the result is just the same. We can also use other negative indices to count from the end. For example, text with the index of negative 2, which is t. The index within the brackets may be calculated in any way. So for example, we can do something like this. 2, and the index may be an expression like 2 plus 3. Now this is evaluated to 5, and this is the same as text with an index of 5, so the result is I. Well, we can even use quite a complex one, like here. Now this whole expression, quite complicated, evaluates to 10. So this is the same as writing text with an index of 10, and the result is T. Now, if you try to use an index which is out of range, you'll get an index error. Let's try to retrieve the element at index 50, which doesn't exist. What we get is an index error saying string index out of range. The index must be an integer. If you try any other type, you'll get a type error. Let's try a float. Text with an index of 5.42. Type error. String indices must be integers. Okay, that's it for this video. If you like it, a thumbs up would be great. Also, make sure to subscribe for future videos. If you want to leave a comment or ask a question, you're welcome to do so. Thanks for watching.